And starting to the top right of the map, here on Merry-Go-Round, our three-player map, we have in game number 8 of the Acer Team Story Cup match between Acer and Millennium, the fourth Millennium player. It is Deishi, and Deishi in blue is going up against a Terran opponent in another TVT series here today. Starting all the way to the bottom of the map, we currently see Innovation, the last man standing for his team, the ace player. He defeated Baby Knight after the Protoss player took down MMA in the game before. So well played so far by Innovation, but can he win two additional games? Keep in mind that if Deishi loses here, we will also see the ace player of Millennium starting to make an appearance, and I would be very surprised if it would be anybody else than 4GG, because 4GG is currently 9-1 in the Acer Team Story Cup during this season. Innovation, pretty strong player himself, but he already lost a couple of games. So we're gonna find out if Innovation for now can take down Deishi, who's going into an early gas here, the same that we see for his opponent. Gas before barracks for both of them. And I am very interested to see what exactly is gonna happen in this particular game right now. We had a couple of Terran versus Terrans already, and I really like the aggression that we see in most of them. We're gonna see Banishes again, for example, with the early gas here. Certainly a big option. We could also instead just see one of the players going through a Raven. We've seen a couple of one base pushes being played by players like Hard. There are so many options that you have in a Terran versus Terran. It's really one of the best mirror matchups in my opinion right now. To be actually absolutely honest with you, I think it's by far the best mirror matchup that we have. The second best would kind of be Protoss versus Protoss if they are not going for Colossi. Because, let's face it for a second, like, who likes laser beam wars? Like, nobody likes that. Players sitting around for 20 minutes and then just, like, the game ending in one engagement that lasts, like, 5 seconds. That's not really what people want to see. Zerg versus Zerg is pretty decent, but we sometimes just have these roach pushes, like, going all crazy. And then, yeah. I think ZvZ and PvP are pretty much the same. There are very amazing games that you can have with that, but there can also be very boring games with the same style. So that's basically one of the problems there. With Terran versus Terran, on the other hand, you don't see that siege tank hopping anymore that we had in Heart of this, Wings of Liberty. So things are pretty awesome right now when it comes to the mirror match tactics in this matchup. And well, we have also a little bit of a deviation going on with Innovation taking the second gas here. It's most likely going to be the Banshee build for him and for his opponent. What we currently have to the top right is still no second refinery. So it's more and more unlikely that Deishi is going for Banshees. Instead, it's more likely that we're going to see a medivac and then maybe a little bit of drop play by him trying to maybe sneak his Hellions in his opponent's main base or just having a bit of a marine drop there. Looks like it's going to be an engineer. No, supply depot for now. Alright. He of course has to think about the possibility that there could be a Banshee opening, because the one thing that he saw earlier is actually, well, thinking about it, he saw nothing. So in terms of scouting information, both of them actually have absolutely no clue what's going on. They don't even know the starting positions, and Deishi is the first one to change that with a Hellion that is now trying to sneak in, has a look over here and was like, well, that was the wrong position immediately. It's a three-player map. The only three-player map that we currently have in the pool, and one of the few that we ever had in this game. So that's going to be a bit interesting to see how it's going to, yeah, just resonate with the players over time. There's also the medivac that we talked about a little bit earlier, and the units are just waiting, especially the Marines here. So let's see how he's going to deal with that, whereas Cloak is being researched for Innovation. And Innovation is getting that scout out that he was hoping for with the SCV straight to the top right, finding out where his opponent spawns so that that Banshee that is about to be completed can immediately move in. And here come the Hellions. Hellions for now just shutting the SCV down, but he saw already that there is no command center on the low ground just yet. We have the medevac moving in, and he's probably going to meet that Banshee very soon. So then he knows what's up. And the same is of course true for Innovation. So both of them like, Innovation turning around with a Banshee here. Well, I'm not quite sure about that, Deishi. Like, what? Alright, he hates Marines. Deishi hates Marines, it is confirmed, you heard it here first. Like, he just leaves them to die. Those Marines had, like, no chance whatsoever. That's basically throwing them out of the medivac without a parachute. That was pretty heartless by him. I really don't like what he did there. And he's losing another unit. Yeah, one Hellion. So Deishi apparently just looking at his units and is like, I hate you all, die. And, well, they did. So now it's time for the Banshee of Innovation to show that at least he's able or she's able to do a bit of damage there. And the SCVs are already dying. It's four of them so far. Killing another one here. That is not really a good start for Daishi. Far from it. Well, he has a Viking moving in right now, but that Banshee found the sweet spot. At least in the vision range, but this is 11 kills. That's 12 kills right there. 13, like, what?! Gets 13 kills, and we have a little bit of damage down at the bottom, but I don't even want to go for the resource lost tab. Like, what did Daishi actually kill? And the answer is, like, 3 SCVs, 1 Banshee, and 9 Marines in the end. But he lost way more, like twice as much nearly. 12 harvesters, and there's even a second Banshee moving in right now. So he was dropping down at the bottom a little bit, but the big story was really the Banshee up here. Not this one, but the one that died, the hero. So Command Center has now started for Innovation. Daishi needs one too. He's far behind. Let's look at the harvester count for a second. 15 to 28, like, oh boy. This is not pretty. Quick snipe on the SCV over here with the medivac, but if that Viking gets even close, yeah, and he will. Bye-bye medivac, and he's gonna lose the units in there as well, doesn't he? Yes, he does. Oh my god. Yeah, Daishi is getting manhandled here right now. That was not the start that he envisioned when he started that gas first. Not at all. He builds his own command center now, of course, but still, he's so far behind, he doesn't even see the taillights of Innovation any longer. 27 against 18, the faster command center down here. Of course, in terms of army supply, Innovation is also having a pretty good position there. Moving cross map now with what he has. And that's also two siege tanks that are there. Three siege tanks by now. Three siege tanks against zero. Let's have a quick look at the upgrades. We do not see any just yet. Stim hasn't even started. But how is Daishi going to stop this? Even with the Raven for a potential point defense drone, if need be. Nice hit here, at least against the siege tank, but still. So there we go. Raven moves in, drops the point defense drone, doesn't help him too much here. No, actually, yes, okay, that makes a lot more sense. Well, it gets a shot off there, and I guess no expansion anytime soon for Daishi, and well, the siege tank on the low ground sieging up. I am very curious to see how he's going to stop that, because the Viking count is also, at least for now, in his favor. If he gets a shot off against the Viking over here, it just means that those siege tanks have a much higher range, thanks to the vision range, at least for now. Supply depots going down, and, well, Innovation, I mean, he is crushing them at this point. Siege tanks, and Banshees are being built here. He kills the supply depots. Daishi is even about to be supplyable. Well, not quite just yet, but that supply depot dying will definitely make it close. Nice! Nice job with that Marine. Finally giving the last hit against his opponent's Viking, and that also takes the high ground vision away. But only for a short time, since the Banshee is now moving in again. And that Banshee can also take down the siege tank here. And that's exactly what he's attacking now. And this is also, of course, the cue for Daishi to move back with it. But yeah, Innovation, he has that base already right there at the natural. He's already started mining, moving in onto the high ground with the siege tanks. And this is a day she doesn't have anything. It's 15 army supply against 47. There's like not a whole lot that he can do with that. Just look at the unit counting station at the top left. 21 Marines against 5, 3 siege tanks against 1 at this point. The siege tank over here is currently surviving a little bit longer than I thought, and well, then it was finished off by the tank of Innovation, and so do the SCVs of Daishi. The GG called, we have the tie in the series, and it has to be the ace player. I want to see 4GG, I want to see Innovation against 4GG, but before we know who the last player is going to be for Team Millennium, we have a short break, and then we are back with the Acer Team Story Cup Season 3 2014. Innovation, the last man standing, bringing us into the ace match.